Karma here, and I'm back with part two of my Texas Teachers videos, or Texas Teachers informational video. I've been out for a while. I'm sorry, with the holiday season coming and going, it's been kind of crazy. Now that school's starting back up, we have report cards due, so I've been doing that. And not just that, but today is actually an off day for us because we have ice on the roads here, so the school district actually closed down and we have an extra day off. So I decided to come and make you guys a video, or an updated video, or a continuation of the last video that I just made. So if you're interested in this Texas Teachers Part 2 video, stay tuned! Alright lovelies, forgive me as I am not wearing any makeup. Today is just a relaxed day, so I'm sorry I kind of look busted or whatever. But it's teacher life. But anywho, okay, so I am going to read off of my notes because I might get lost or I might forget something. In the last video that I made, it was kind of all over the place. So I really didn't have it structured. I was trying to just think. So this time, I decided to write everything out. Now, this is the things that I'm going to talk about are things that you have to do during your probationary period, your first year of teaching. So there's only, what, one, two, three, maybe four or five things that you have to do. So it's not a whole lot. The first thing is you do have to have 50 professional development hours that you have to get approved. So with those, with your professional development hours, it's just something that, you know, meetings or trainings that you have during school and stuff. It can even be trainings that are done outside of school. You just have to get your supervisor's approval. And that way they can go towards your 50 hours. Now me, how I got my 50 hours was, I did two trainings in the summer prior to even starting as a teacher, because your trainings can only be used, or I think it's 60 days before your first day and 60 days after, if I'm not mistaken. So if it's like 61 days that you got, you know, that training done or whatever, they won't count it. It has to be within that 60 days before your first day during your school year, and then 60 days after that first school year. So you have all that time to get it done. I actually got mine done, all of them, before my first date of teaching. And I think it was 60 days, yeah. So I got all mine done before then. And I did two trainings in the summer that my school paid for, which were both 6 hours. And then I did a training on my own that I didn't even know I could use those hours until I just tried it. Training on my own, which was worth 40 hours, this training. And it's just a local registered behavior technician type training. So that was worth 40 hours. And I, you know, did that in a matter of, you know, weeks. And I just used it for my professional development. So before I even started working, I already had all my 50 hours. So I was done with that. So you do need your 50 hours of professional development. Next is your internship projects. I believe there are 7 to 8 projects that are online. And all you have to do, I think, maybe 4 of them are like 5 questions that you answer. And then the other ones you have to actually type or answer questions. And it's kind of like, how would you arrange your classroom? How do you manage behavior type thing? And they give you guidelines. You can honestly knock all those out in 1 week, if you, or less. If you wanted to, you can knock them out in a day. But those internship projects, you know, you can submit them like that. There's nothing to it but to do it. So if you give yourself a good, if you're dedicated and you give yourself a week at least, you can knock them all out. You can knock them out in a day, but if you do a week, you'll be fine. Your coach, next is the coach observations. Now your coach, or, you know, your, what do they call them? I guess they just call them your coach. They come and observe your classroom. And they observe your classroom 3 times during the school year. My coach has so far came 1 time. So there are 2 more times that he has to come and observe my classroom. And they grade you, they critique you, they, you know, all that stuff. They don't do it right then and there. But when they go into your classroom, they kind of sit off in the back and you're just kind of teaching and doing your thing. And they're, I think they have to be there for a minimum of 30 minutes or an hour. I think it's 30 minutes or an hour. I don't know. I think it's an hour. But they have to be there for a minimum amount of time. And once they're there, they just exit quietly. Mine, he was actually pretty good. He took his notes. He sent me the notes of what he took. and what he thinks I should do. I mean, they'll kind of critique you. So then the next time they come, you can, you know what to expect. And then they come a third time after that. You do have to give them your lesson plan in advance, so that way they can be prepared for, or they can know what's going to be happening in your class. And you also have to have a printout copy ready for them when they get there, so that they can look at it as you're doing, you know, your lesson. But that's pretty much it. They come and observe. If you have any questions that you have for them and stuff, you can ask them. They help you. If you have any concerns about things, you know, you ask them. They're there to basically be your coach, your mentor, and all that stuff. So mine so far came once, and he needs to come two more times. And they'll schedule it with you, so they'll contact you and say, hey, are you available on this day? At this time, will you be there? Yes or no? And you go from there. But they'll schedule it. And I'm sure mines will come within the next week or two. He'll be back. But they do have to come three times during the whole school year. The next thing, which is the last thing, is your PPR review, which is a test that you have to take. You have to take the review. And in order for you to be approved to take the test, you have to pass the review first. This is the part that I'm on. I've actually finished about more than halfway, which hopefully I can finish it up today. But more than halfway, I finished the review. And all you have to do is like a practice test, and they give you 90 questions and you answer the test, or you answer the questions. Once you pass that, then you're approved to take the PPR exam, which is $130. And you need to take that exam before the end of your teaching year. You need to pass that exam too. So right now I'm doing the review part and the practice exam. If you fail the practice exam, because you have to pass it in order to get approved, if you fail it, they let you retake it again and again until you pass it, so that way you can take the real one. But the real one is $130 just to take it. And so far, since I'm on that part, I'm hoping I can just take it as soon as I'm like done. Because if you fail the actual real one, you are, I think, able to retake it up to three times or four times, something like that. So I'm hoping I pass it on my first time, my first trial. And then that's it. Like, once you do all those things, then, you know, you're done. Like, you're done. And I'm on literally my last part, which is finishing up my practice exam so I can take the real one. And then my Texas teacher guy, my coach, has to come two more times, and that I really have no control over. I just have to wait till he contacts me, but he has to come two more times before I can be done with that section. But that's it. Like, that is all you have to do. I feel like the bulk of the work was done prior to becoming the teacher. Everything else you can really knock out in 6 months. And they, you know, they do recommend the first 6 months of teaching, but in reality, it's that probationary period. You have that time to get it done. So as long as you get it done, there was this girl who works at my job, and she didn't get her PPR test done until like 2 weeks before the next school year started. So it had to be done before her, a year from her hire date as a teacher, that first year, she had to get it done and get it passed. The risk with that is if you fail it, you do have to wait a period of time before you can retake the test. So don't wait till the last minute. Get it done as soon as possible. I'm hoping that I can get my PPR test done either later this month or sometime next month. I want to take it. If I failed it, I want to have enough time to take it again. If I fail it then, I want to have enough time to take it again. So you don't want to wait till the last minute and hope you make it on the first trial. Because I think you have to wait like 30 days before you can retake the test again or something like that. So you really don't want to wait till the last minute. If you guys have any questions about this part two of my video, please feel free to leave a comment below and I will get right back to you as soon as I can. I did want to rush through this video real quick because I hate it when YouTubers talk all, you know, for a very long time. Like, I'm already at a certain amount of minutes and I'm like, oh, it's too long. But if you guys have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave them below, and I will talk to you lovelies later. Bye-bye!